Hello everyone, this is Dr. Santosh. Today we will be talking about a very interesting topic, that is catabolism of threonine. Actually, this is a series of lecture in amino acid catabolism, third in the series of the lecture in amino acid catabolism. And this metabolism, amino acid catabolism, as all amino acid catabolism, this threonine catabolism occurs during fasting state. That is prolonged fasting state. Remember, when we are talking about amino acid catabolism, we are talking about the catabolism during fasting state, especially prolonged fasting state, prolonged fasting condition. So that is why this is a fasting state metabolism. Now let's begin with the topic. Threonine is an essential amino acid. Essential amino acid, hydroxyl group containing essential amino acid, which has four carbon. Just remember, the number of carbon is very important. Four carbon. One, obviously, because this is amino acid, one will be acid, and second carbon, with second carbon there will be binding of NaOH, and additional two carbon are there, and third carbon OH group is attached, and fourth carbon has hydrogen. And it produces glucose as well as ketone body. Remember the pathway. It is very easy to remember pathway. If you remember the structure of this threonine, and one more thing, if you remember the structure of few simple amino acid, it's not that difficult to remember glycine. Two carbon amino acid, simplest amino acid, glycine. This is the glycine, and add to hydrogen, that's it. So this is glycine. So if you remember the structure of glycine, threonine, next simplest amino acid, one carbon less than this is, what's serine? One carbon less than this is serine. Serine has one carbon less and same hydroxyl group containing amino acid. So if you remember these three structure, and one more structure, modified form of this, I'll modify this little bit. So three carbon compound with one CO group, this is pyruvate. Remember, if you remember this all structure, simple structure, then the pathway will become very, very easy. Now let's come to the point that threonine is an essential amino acid, and which is gluconeogenic as well as ketogenic. And it is very interesting to note that this, as a gluconeogenic amino acid, this is the only amino acid that will join this Krebs cycle. This will join Krebs cycle as pyruvate as well as a succinate. No other amino acid has such privilege to join as two intermediate. Only threonine can join as two intermediate. And one more thing, it is a ketogenic amino acid also. And threonine has three pathways to form this pyruvate and succinate. Among that three pathway, two pathway, pyruvate will be formed. And third pathway will form succinate. We'll see how does it do that. So let's see the Krebs cycle, where it join this gluconeogenic pathway. So threonine, you can see here threonine. So threonine here will join as pyruvate. Two pathway. One pathway number one and pathway number two. Through this two pathway, threonine will join as pyruvate. And this third pathway, threonine will join as succinate. And it will join as succinate through propionic acid pathway. I have already done lecture on propionic acid pathway and propionic acid. Please go and watch that video also. After it converts into this, pyruvate here converts into oxaloacetate. This oxaloacetate will form phosphoenol pyruvate. And this phosphoenol pyruvate, ultimately, through several steps, it will form glucose. And remember, this catabolism is happening during fasting condition, prolonged fasting condition. This is very important. Prolonged fasting condition means glucagon level in the blood is very high, and ketone fatty acid oxidation is also happening in the body. Ketone body formation is happening in the body. So these are the gluconeogenesis is happening in the body. This is the fasting state metabolism. So during fasting state, threonine will convert into pyruvate into oxaloacetate, and oxaloacetate will ultimately convert into glucose. Now here what will happen? Threonine will convert into succinate, and succinate will convert into fumarate, and fumarate into oxaloacetate. And see, oxaloacetate never converts into this. Oxaloacetate converts into phosphoenolpyruvate and glucose, because the Krebs cycle is a broken cycle during prolonged fasting condition. It is not complete cycle. The purpose of this Krebs cycle is formation of glucose only during prolonged fasting condition. The purpose of Krebs cycle is glucose synthesis. Now let's talk about the pathway of how threonine produces glucose. Let's see how threonine will end up into glucose. Now let's see this first pathway. If you can see this first pathway, you can note that threonine, as I have already told you, is made up of four carbon. So two carbon, if you can see the product, reactant plus product things, if you don't focus anything in between, just watch this, see starting product, starting reaction, reactant and final product. If you see the starting reactant, you will see four carbon here. Four carbon compound is broken down into two carbon. So like stick breaks, just remember, it breaks into two pieces. So one piece is containing two carbon, and this is glycine, and other pieces containing acetyl coenzyme. From this acetyl coenzyme, ketone body will form. Now let's have a look at the pathway. So first will be, what will happen? This group will be dehydrogenated. So this hydrogen will be removed, and this will convert into keto group. This carbon will convert into keto group, and after that break of this compound. The compound name is alpha amino beta keto butyric acid. We can, in short, we can A, K and B. So this AKB lyase, alpha amino keto butyrate lyase, will break this bond here, and it will, the two compound will be generated. One is acetyl coenzyme, one is glycine, and this glycine will convert into glucose. So how we will see that? Now second pathway will also produce glycine and acetyl coenzyme, same product like the first pathway have, same product. One is acetyl coenzyme, other is glycine. Here what happens, the first step is itself a breaking of step. So it first step itself break the this compound into two. So this aldolase means, aldolase is a lyase which will break this compound into two. Now this will break into compound into two, this threonine into glycine and acetaldehyde. Acetaldehyde ultimately will convert into acetyl coenzyme. So you can see glycine and acetyl coenzyme is also being produced through the second pathway. And this acetyl coenzyme, this glycine will again convert into glucose. How? Let's see how it converts. So what will happen is glycine will convert into serine through enzyme called hydroxymethyl transferase. So glycine hydroxymethyl transferase will utilize methylene tetrahydrofolate. Tetrahydrofolate. Here also methylene tetrahydrofolate. So folate plus vitamin B6 all will also be utilized to convert this glycine to serine. Now carbon in serine comes from this tetrahydrofolate. This serine will ultimately be converted into pyruvate, and pyruvate, as I've already discussed, pyruvate will convert into oxaloacetate. Now oxaloacetate will ultimately convert into glucose. Now let's see the third pathway. So this is the third pathway. It is catalyzed by threonine deaminase or dehydrogenase. This is non-oxidative deaminase reaction where vitamin B6 is required. So serine and threonine can undergo this non-oxidative deamination and require vitamin B6. Vitamin B6 catalyzes non-oxidative deamination. This non-oxidative deamination will directly produce alpha-keto butyrate. This is alpha keto group, and this is butyrate, four compound alpha keto butyrate. So alpha keto butyrate will convert into propionic acid by releasing carbon dioxide and one NADH. So after this, this whole propionic acid will convert into, through propionic acid pathway, it will convert into succinate, and succinate will convert into glucose. So I have already discussed about this propionic acid pathway. So So go and watch that video. You can see this is all our two-step process. Just remember the final product, initial product, and remember the structure. If you remember the structure, you will remember this product easily, because this picture of the structure will stick to your mind. The word does not stick to our mind. So you, this is how this is how this threonine will produce succinate and glucose. This is how through this pathway it will produce pyruvate, and pyruvate will produce glucose. So thank you for watching this video.